Following his initial request late last year, Vice Speaker BJ Cruz says he's relieved with news from the Attorney General of Guam made on Thursday.
As I said in the beginning, I thought that she would do the right thing, and I believe that she now has done the right thing.
As we reported, the AG's office announced it will hire an independent prosecutor to further investigate and determine whether charges are warranted for the illegal retro bonus payments given to 107 Adeloup staffers in December 2014.
My only concern is that I'm hoping that when they write the RFP, that the RFP does not just limit itself to reviewing the 2014 retroactive pay, because I believe that the 2015 retroactive pay reimbursement is probably worse than the first one.
Under Guam law, the final contract must be executed by the governor of Guam. Governor Eddie Calvo says from the beginning, his administration has been open.
There's nothing from our side, but I welcome it, and I look forward to the investigation.
Calvo admits mistakes were made in the process of the retro bonus payments, but says he will extend the courtesy and transparency to the independent prosecutor.
What I have done as a governor was perfectly under the legal authority that I was given. Obviously, there were issues, and we acknowledge that at certain levels in the processing at DOA, mistakes were made. That's not criminal activity. There are mistakes that were made. I don't know whether the same can be said about the legislature.
Governor Calvo is referring to the legislature's handling of the Capital District Fund. Adeloup has accused the legislature of illegally taking money out of the fund and using it for operations.
We're an open book and we're transparent. At the same time, I want to ensure that all branches of government, where we see that there are issues, that there also needs to be investigation.
Calvo recently wrote to the AG asking for a legal review of the legislature's handling of the fund. As for the independent prosecutor, the AG's office says they plan to issue the RFP by next week. Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Ken Quintaniza.